Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome guys. Today we will start with the thin layer chromatography lab. Today, shabab, to understand the thin layer chromatography, we need to understand the main concept of the chromatography. I know that you didn't take a course regarding to the chromatography. So to understand the part, because the thin layer chromatography is a part of the chromatography. So like here, to start the story from the beginning, we need to understand what it does mean chromatography itself. What does mean chromatography? We say the shabab, and the main definition of the chromatography is how to separate a different compounds of the molecule from the mixtures. So here, this is, I mean, the main definition is a separation of a different molecules from a mixtures. Means that I have a mixture. So if you have a mixture in your hand here, this mixture, for example, is contained here. I have a mixture. If this mixture is containing protein, lipid, and other molecules, could be DNA and whatsoever. It's a mixture dissolved here. So if I'd like to remove the only protein, how I can do it? This is the technique called chromatography. If you are able to make a separation for a different molecule from a mixture, this is the name of the chromatography. Let me give you an example, shabab. So for example here, if I have this column, this column, shabab, is designed for protein, for example, for protein verification. So what it will have? It will have in between something called resin. Look. So this is a solid phase. This is a shabab solid phase here. It's called resin. So here, if I would like, I have the tube. This tube of mixtures. I have mixtures here. This tube of shabab of mixtures. It contains protein, it contains DNA, contains some lipids, contains some phospholipid and some other factors here. What all I need? I need only to separate the protein from this mixture. How I can separate this protein by using, for example, this column chromatography? This is an example. Number one, they say you have to dissolve this mixture in something called mobile phase. This number one. You better dissolve this mixture in Asia in a mobile phase. If number one, the first step in the chromatography, the first step usually in the chromatography is to dissolve. First step is to dissolve in mixtures in AOLED, يلا زي ما قلنا فوق, in mobile phase. Number one. Type. What about number two? And they said number two is to pass this solution or this mixtures, which it dissolve in the mobile phase through a Muhammad electro stationary phase. Three minute stationary, shabab, stationary phase. What I mean by stationary phase here? This resin is working as stationary phase. Usually the stationary, shabab, usually in our case become solid. Most of the case become solid. So here it have the resin. So what I mean? How to pass this mixture through the stationary phase, the mixtures which dissolve in mobile phase, actually this is the one which allow all component dissolve in. So this was the case here. So what they said, Muhammad, this resin is very specific to protein. Again, very specific to protein. Good. So this resin today is specific for protein. And we have other resin. It could be specific for DNA. And we have other resin. It could be specific for vitamins or lipids or whatever. Usually the resin, the key points here is, key point, secret point here is a secret word here in the resin. Mean, this the one for protein, that mean will attach with the protein. This the one for DNA, that mean will attach the DNA. So what will do? We'll go to the second step, pass this mixture through the stationary phase. So this mixture, I will put it through here. What will happen, ya shabab? Look, this mixture here, it will go through the solution. I said, the resin is specific for whom? For protein. So the protein will attached. Good. Protein will, ya shabab, will attach. But this is, ya shabab, this is the protein. The protein will attach. So what about the remaining? The remaining will get out. So by centrifuge, you can get out the other components. The only protein, the one would attach with the solution. Perfect. So what happened later on? We will do another step, which is called washing. So I will wash, put some washing to make the protein, in this case, clear. Perfect, shabab. So here, the protein, only the one which will be attached. After that, we'll go last step, which is called the elution. I will not explain this one here. Elution means after you wash it, everything is clear, you have some solution to get your protein back. So now what you did actually, you separate the protein. You prepare your protein for further steps if you need for further research, for further medication, dawa, whatsoever, drugs, whatsoever here. So, shabab, this is the idea of the chromatography. I will dissolve my mixtures in mobile phase, and I will pass my mobile phase through the stationary phase, which usually solid, which is has a specificity to one of the molecule that I have. The remaining, I don't need all of this, but I just need the protein which is attached. I have a question here. If I have, in this case, in the stationary phase, the principle, they said, if your molecules or your compounds, if your compounds, shabab, it's high affinity with the stationary phase, high affinity, this will make it fast moving or slow moving. Yalla, tell me. High affinity with the stationary phase means it attach, it stick with the stationary, stick with it. So means slow or fast, stick means slow. But high affinity with the stationary phase means slow movement. صح كده شباب, to able to separate. To be able to, شباب, to separate. طيب, what about the low affinity? The low affinity with the stationary phase. Give me example here, which is low affinity. Other DNA with lipid, with phospholipid, and all these molecules, they are low affinity with this resin. That's why they get out. So low affinity in this case will be fast moving. Will be, شباب, fast moving. يبقى here, the secret words here. Two things. Number one, you have the resin or the stationary phase should be specific to the molecule you are looking for. Number two, you have to become high affinity. If it becomes high affinity, that means slow movement, it will take it back and will release everything else with low affinity with them. So after that, you can get it purified by another method like elution. So here, this is the main concept of chromatography. Type. They said, do you have, Muhammad? Do you have with the chromatography types? Oh, we have many types of chromatography. So here, let's go to the types of chromatography. We have actually more than 8 to 9, I would say 12 type of chromatography. So type, what here we need to look for? So I will look for the main important one that we need here. That's why I will just mention the one I need here for my lab, not general one. Because as I told you, we have many, many, many type of chromatography, and I put it in the PowerPoint that I sent through the Blackboard. But here, let me go to the number one, which is called chromatographic bed shape. Chromatographic bed shape. It's like a bed. So here, for example, if you give me a second, so shabab, here, this what I mean, the chromatographic bed shape, like this shape. It's like here a glass, we have here silica gel, this is for the thin layer chromatography. So we have two types. For the chromatographic bed shape, we have number one, our lab today, number one TLC, our thin layer chromatography. This which is TLC. And we have the second one, which is called, this one I explained here, column chromatography. Here we have this, the first type. So what is the second type? The second type is, for example, one of the most important type of chromatography, they call affinity chromatography. In affinity chromatography, shabab, it contain super critical liquid. And this is very important and very expensive, and that's why you'll find most of the product to get from the affinity chromatography, actually they are very pure. So this is the second type for the affinity. One of the most important that I need you to understand it, because it will be related to your work for the future, the one code or one depend on the techniques depend on the depend on الموبايل فيز او الموبايل فيز. So I will just remove the button which is depend on يا شباب on the phase on the mobile phase characteristics. Like يا محمد, this is very important. Like a liquid chromatography, a liquid chromatography, and we have a gas chromatography. A gas يا ولاد chromatography. So both of them very important. A liquid chromatography, they mentioned LC liquid chromatography and GC gas chromatography. So here, for example, a liquid, both of them very, very important. And most of the proteins separated in our life, they use these two techniques, either the gas or the liquid. Again, the separation of protein use liquid chromatography. That's why this is the common in the protein world. But here, it gives you analytical. I forgot to tell you a very important point here. Look, شباب, here for the chromatography, we have two main functions. Either analytical or preparation. Preparation or separation and separation. So how many function we have generally for the chromatography? Two function, either analytical or preparation or separation. What I mean by analytical, it can get, tell you which molecules compound that you have. It can tell you, so I have this amino acid, particular amino acid, give you the name by comparing to the standard. But what I mean by the separation and preparation, like this case, I can separate my protein from a compound, so I can reuse it again. So we have two functions actually for the chromatography. A liquid chromatography, one of the main for both of them, by the way, liquid chromatography can make analysis and also can prepare and separate the sample. But the gas chromatography, it's mainly for analytical. It tells you which compound you have, which vitamins, which lipids, depend on the standard that you use and the reference. But without telling you the actual, without giving you any preparation or separation. And actually the gas chromatography, it depends on the boiling point for each compound, boiling point for each compound. I mean, it goes through the column, and this column with very high temperature, it goes to the evaporation, and there is a sign it gets from each compound by the evaporation. So this is the main idea. That's why you lost your sample here. But in the liquid chromatography, it can give you a peaks, and you can separate the peak. Even if you need to separate, you can separate. If you don't need, you just for analytical, it will go through the analytical. We have a huge courses regarding to the chromatography, by the way, very important, especially for our colleague everywhere. I mean MLS, I mean our nutrition and even nursing. This is very important, for example, for the vaccine nowadays preparation. So you use one of these chromatography methods to purify the protein used for vaccine. So we have many, many other airship and many other types. And LEC, it has many types, like مثلا, high performance liquid chromatography. We have LCMS, and there is another LCMS-MS. And we have UPLC Ultra Performance Liquid Chromatography. We have many type, even Malto, and we have many type under the liquid, ya shabab, liquid chromatography. So this one of the example. We have another one which used a separation mechanism. This is the last one I will speak about it. We have many other one like a separation mechanism. This one used only for separation. The most important two, and you need to know, even to hear about this name, ion exchange chromatography, number one, ion exchange chromatography, and this the one depend on, شباب, as you see, depend on the ion, depend on the charge. So depend on the charge, I can use the ion exchange chromatography. The second one, I would say, size exclusion chromatography, size exclusion chromatography, and also this one, use the size plus the ion of the amino acid or any protein or anything you need to separate. تمام? So here, شباب, here this is a type of the, what here I explained for the column chromatography. This is one example for the column chromatography. So now, شباب, we will go to the our example today, which is thin layer chromatography, TLC. Look at شباب, a TLC, as we said and we explained, this is our example of the chromatographic bed shape. So what happened here in the TLC? As I told you, شباب, the TLC actually is contained. Look here, we have the glass, this glass here, and this here we have, which is called silica gel. Look to the silica gel. So here, I'll just show, because it's one layer, I'll just show you here. It's one layer of the silica on the glass. So the what one layer of the silica on the glass. What will be the first step? So how we, in which, actually, we, where we use the main usage of the three-layer chromatography, number one, it's used generally for the non-volatile compound. Usually, for the non-volatile compounds, give me an example, Muhammad, it's like a protein, it's like amino acids, it's like drugs, it's like antibiotics for one of the drugs, of course. So here, these are the main usage for the thin layer chromatography. Tell me how it used, how it works. Look at Banat here. As I told you here, we have the glass on the other side and we have the silica gel here in the other side, in this side. The silica gel in this side, it this is the one which is the stationary phase. This is شباب, the stationary phase. طب, what about the mobile phase? So here, the first step number one, we will take, we'll draw a line after 2 centimeters from here and here. After that, we put equal spot to add our known and unknown mixtures. So today we are doing TLC for different amino acids. So we will have 3 known and 1 unknown, like I, as I draw here. And this very explained in the practical part. So here we have histidine, glycine, proline. This is known spot. I will put the spot here. And I have a mixture with the unknown. So here, how I draw it. After that, I will just add 5 microliters from the each one of them. After that, I will put it in the jar with a mobile phase for 1 hour after, and will follow the focus step. So how it works? So I will have the jar here. This is the jar. It's contained mobile, شباب, mobile phase. This is the mobile phase. This is our, شباب, our mobile phase. Yeah, but this is the phase, this is the mobile phase, or this is the solvent which goes through the thin layer chromatography. After that, I will have the thin layer chromatography bed, sorry, in this shape. I will put it in this shape in the solution. After that, as I told you before, we will, شباب, we should be here. We will draw the spot. Now, we put it here in the mobile phase and we drew an equal spot here and here and here. This should be equal spot, like this way. Now we have equal spot here. And we add the known amino acid and we add the unknown here. After that, what will happen? This mobile phase will move. This mobile phase, butanol. This mobile phase today for the amino acid is consist of butanol, and acetic acid. And we have water, which is 8 ml and 5 ml of acetic acid and 7 ml of water. This is the component of our mobile phase today. So the mobile phase after that will move through the thin layer diffusion. It will be diffused through the thin layer chromatography. That's why after 1 hour, I will just remove it from the jar. After you remove it from the jar, what you'll do, the first step, you will take the line. I will make the line a little bit upper here because we need to for calculation. So after you remove from the jar, you will take up to the solvent reach, you will take your line. Shabab, here, this is the mobile phase. What about the stationary phase? Where we'll find it? Here. The thin layer, which is the silica gel. This is our, شباب, our stationary, شباب, our stationary phase. So that's why we are pass the mobile phase through the stationary phase. Through the passing, what will happen? But the first step, if you would like to write the steps here, the first step, I will draw the line. Draw the first line. I will, number two, I will add spot equally. Space with equally, شباب, with equally space here in the first line. Number three, I will add a known and known and unknown amino acids. How much I will add? 5 microliter. I will add this 5 microliter in the spot. As I told you, the first one was histidine, glycine, and proline, and this one unknown. So I will add 5 microliter on the spot here, as I told. And I will keep it dry. After that, I will put it, put on a mobile phase for diffusion. 1 hour. After you put it, with this very important step, after you remove, what will be the first step after remove? Hey, shabab, draw the solvent line. Draw a solvent line here. This the one. Draw the solvent line. This is the first step after remove. After you remove, type. After that, will number 6 will be dry using sishwa. Now, after step number 7, we will add the most important dye, which is non-hydrin. And this non-hydrin, it's very important dye for amino acid. Mumtaz, ya Muhammad. After you add the non-hydrin, again, step number 8, I will dry, as I show you in the video. I will show you in the video for the practical. So now you dry. After you dry, you will step number 9, and this is the last step, calculate the retention factor. What I mean by retention factor? RF. What I mean by retention factor, Shabab? So I will explain the retention factor. The retention factor, I would say, the first amino acid it reach here. The second amino acid it reach here. The third amino acid it reach here. What about the unknown? The first one of the unknown after colored it was here. And the second one was here. But tell me the name. But the first one it's equal to this part. But the first one histidine. The second one here it equal to proline. This means the proline. But now we identify them. Step number 1, identify. Step number 2, calculate the RF. What is the RF? It's the distance of the amino acid divided by the whole distance. يبقى هنا نكتب يا شباب. يبقى ال RF, the retention factor, distance by, moved by amino acid, divided by distance moved by a solvent. So, here for example, the distance of the solvent here, start from here till here, I will say this is A. And the distance of this amino acid, for example, from here until here, it's B. So it will be, shabab, B divided on A. But the distance by the amino acid, by the whole distance. It's equal to, shabab, B divided A. So how we can do it, ya Muhammad? We'll just measure it by the ruler. How many centimeter here divided by how many centimeter there, you will get your RF. So here now, shabab, if now we finish, I think, the thin layer chromatography, how we use it practically, and even in the natural and the next video with the practical, it will be these things very clear and very easy, and this very easy, shabab lab. Again, thin layer chromatography used for the non-volatile compounds. Thank you very much. Inshallah, hope to see you in the next video, and goodbye. Bye-bye, shabab. Shukran khair.